everybody, welcome back to Kim's Kitchen. Today we're going to be making a good old-fashioned peanut butter cookie together. I have very fond memories of these cookies. After a long day, my mother would bake them for me and the whole house would smell of this peanut buttery, amazing goodness. And I can't wait to share this recipe with you. My daughters love it and I'm sure you will too. It's super easy to get together in no time at all. We're going to make the mixture and bake in the oven without chilling or any fuss like that. You're gonna love it and you're gonna wanna make it over and over again. So if you're ready, let's get started. These are the ingredients for the peanut butter cookies. 1.5 cup of all-purpose flour, 3/4 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 cup of butter, which is unsalted, 1 cup of unsweetened peanut butter, 1/2 cup of brown sugar, 1/2 cup of normal sugar, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, and 1 large egg. Before we get started, I would first like to talk about some ingredients that we're going to be using today. The first one is the flour. So what I did to measure the flour is to scoop it out with a spoon into the measuring cup and then to level it off with a knife to ensure that I'm using the proper amount. If I use too much flour, the consistency of the cookie may change. So make sure you measure it properly. So here, as you can see, I have measured 1.5 cups of flour, but I scaled this, so make sure you do that properly. And the second thing I would like to talk about is the peanut butter. So I'm using natural peanut butter today. This peanut butter has no sugars in it or no additives at all. It's completely natural. And in the jar, if you use natural peanut butter as well, you can see that the top has a layer of oil. So you want to make sure to mix your peanut butter, if it's a natural peanut butter, mix it with a spoon and then you can measure it. If you're using sweetened peanut butter, you should reduce the amount of sugar in the recipe. So we're using today 1/2 cup of brown sugar and 1/2 cup of white sugar. So if you're going to be using sweetened peanut butter, make sure to reduce the amount of sugar in the recipe by 2 tablespoons. Otherwise, your cookie is gonna be way too sweet. So once we start making these cookies, they get together in no time at all. So make sure you have your baking tray ready with parchment paper, or if you have a silk pad like this, these are perfect as well, since cookies do not stick to this and you don't waste paper. So have your oven tray ready with parchment paper or silk pad. And you can also turn on your oven at this point to about 175 degrees centigrade or 350 degrees Fahrenheit. So the first thing we're going to do is to get a bowl, add in the flour by sifting it, add the salt, add the baking powder, and sift it into the bowl. Maybe you'll want to use a bigger bowl than I did because it's kind of overflowing here. So get a bigger bowl than I did. So you basically want to mix the baking powder, the salt, and the flour together in one bowl, and preferably a bigger bowl than mine. So here, we're gonna set this aside for now. Now we're gonna get our stand mixer. So with our stand mixer, we're going to use the paddle attachment, and we're going to cream the butter and the sugars together first. So I'm adding my softened butter. Make sure it's softened, otherwise you'll have a lot of difficulty to make a smooth batter. This is a very important step to make sure that your butter is at room temperature. And now I'm going to add in the sugars. This is light packed brown sugar. Basically, you need to pack it. Packing means to press it so that it doesn't go all over the place. Brown sugar and granulated white sugar into the butter. And now we're gonna cream this. If you don't have a paddle attachment and you don't have a mixer, that is fine. You can use electrical hand mixer as well. So make sure the sugar is well incorporated with the butter. So I'm gonna mix it just a little bit more. That should be good. And now we're going to go ahead and add in the peanut butter. So we're going to mix the peanut butter and the butter until well incorporated. Okay, that should be good now. We're going to go ahead and add in the rest of the ingredients. I'm going to crack in the egg. I'm going to crack it separately just in case there are any eggshells. I don't want to put it in there, so I'm going to crack it here for safety reasons. And then I'm going to add it into the bowl. And now we're going to add in the vanilla. And we're going to give it one more mix. Okay, our last part is adding in the flour, but before doing that, I want to just give it one scrape on the side of the bowl just to make sure all the ingredients have been blended well. So with the spatula, just one mix on the side of the bowl will be great. And then we are ready to add in our final ingredient, which is the flour mixture here. So I'm going to add the flour mixture now. We're going to beat this low until just incorporated. Don't over mix it, please. Just slow. Make sure it's incorporated, but do not over mix on low. So that should be good. Now let's open it and see what our batter looks like. You see, it's this thick dough. We have not over mixed it. This is perfect and exactly what we're looking for. Now we finished making the dough mixture. It was really, really easy to make. And the next step is to form it into little ball shapes. And since this is a dense cookie, it won't spread easily in the oven without our help. So we're gonna flatten it slightly, and then we're gonna take a fork and make a crisscross shape on the cookie, which makes the good old-fashioned peanut butter cookie. Here is our dough mixture. We're going to basically grab some dough and form them into ball shapes. Make sure they are all the same size because we want to bake them evenly. So this would be a good size. It's about 40 grams, approximately 40 grams per cookie. So if you're a bit of a perfectionist, you can go ahead and measure them, but there's really no need. If they look the same size, that's pretty good. So you want to leave a little bit of a space between them because we are going to flatten them eventually. Get all your dough. This should make about 18 cookies, depending really on the size of the balls that you shape. You're gonna see how much we are forming today, but usually it's about 18 cookies. Here I have about 14 cookies. Because I made them a little bit larger than I usually do. So you can get up to about 15 to 16 easily if you make them smaller or even smaller, it's up to you really. But the most important thing is that all of them are pretty much the same size. And right now we're gonna slightly press them to flatten them. Slightly press them, not too much, with the palm of your hands. It's okay if they are a little bit cracked on the side. That's really no problem. It gives an extra homemade charm to them. So now that we have pressed them, we're going to get a fork. It should be a big fork, please, not a small fork, because we want to see the lines on top, the crisscross lines. So we're going to do one side like this, one side like that. And that is the crisscross shape. Going to go ahead and do this to all of the cookies. Now our cookies are ready to go into the oven. We're going to bake them for about 9 to 10 minutes. Keep an eye on these because we don't want to make them a brownish color. We want them to stay golden. After we take them out of the oven, they will harden up as they cool down and they continue to bake a little more. So make sure you keep an eye on them. While we're waiting for the cookies to bake, this would be a great time for you to go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and click on the like button below. Please leave your comments because I would love to know what you think and get notified of the next videos that I'll be sharing in the future. By the way, you don't have to bake the cookies right away. You can always bake them later as long as you cover them well with plastic wrap and then store it in the fridge. It's been 10 minutes. I'm going to get them out of the oven now. Let's check it together. There it is, golden in color, not brown. We're gonna let it to rest at room temperature until it cools down. And this is when it gets hardened. So we're gonna let it rest now. I'm gonna drizzle mine with some extra peanut butter. Very tender, very peanut buttery, so delicious. Definitely try it. I'm gonna dunk mine in some almond milk. Today we made good old fashioned peanut butter cookies together. They were super easy to make and I hope you enjoy eating them as much as I do. Please let me know what you think in the comments below. I would love to hear from you. And don't forget to click on the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. See you soon on Kim's Kitchen. Bye.